I do. The word you say the day you are married. Whether your wedding is a small, informal ceremony or a large traditional with all of the trimmings, it is surely one of the most important days of your life. In the space of that small I do, your relationship is transformed into something holy. You've stood before family and friends and pledged your life to one another. You've promised to love each other for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, till death do us part. You've committed to a lifetime of love and promised, blessed by God. And it can last as long as the promise of God, love remains. Once again, families and friends, ladies and gentlemen, the bridal entourage, the candle sponsors, Mr. Felcris and Mrs. Raquel Orjaleza, Officiating Minister, Reverend Pastor Jerome S. Liraza. Last man, Mr. John Ray Licera. Maid of Honor, each the best, Miss Maricar Carvajal. Groom with parents, Mr. Alvin Agogio, Mr. Alan Agogio, and Mrs. Evelyn Agogio. Principal sponsors, Mr. Lucio and Mrs. Jane Pamaybay. Tresha Camino. Ian Gibbs, Buong, and Yen Putang. Riello Orjaleza and Maria Hilda Tubula. Bible bearer, Eljun Kizoy. Rain bearer, St. John Orjaleza. Coin bearer, Jundale Orjaleza. Flower girls, Sue Igot. bride. Mr. Eliodoro or Haleza, and Mrs. Prima or Haleza. And now let us all rise. Let us all rise and let us welcome our lovely bride. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Elma or Haleza.
Ako karon sa inyo matagpangan na kata. Nagpasalamat sa nagpasalamat niya yan, ang itugot mo na isaling niyo sa ilma sa kuha. O karon ako sa nakos niyo matagpangan na nagpasaling hanggang sa akong pagkabatayon akong ikaw ba naman sa ilma sa akong tumok akong pagkina. Mga salamat kayo sa inyo. Salamat kayo nga si Ilma na nagtubo na may kanong sa inyo. May kanong sa inyo, mama. Ako kasi ang blessing sa mga pinaguhi. Magkaroon na karoon ng adlaw na ikaw yung si Ilma na sa inyo. Salamat kayo, mama.
Ang halang ikasulti nga nakatunta nga magtiayo na mo magsimulta na yun at kaya na naman siya na ang tiyan ay away nagpanta nga magoy-oy mo magsimulta na yun mo kaya maharado na yun to ang ikinahinan sa itong kinabuhay nga magka-oy-oy ta salamat sa tunin mo nga sabot raga kung sa inyong mga problema ni Ilma. Salamat din, salamat po kayo.
Pasalamatan ko ninyo kay gidawat ko ninyo. Salamat sa pagkanap ko ni Alvin na daw sa Ginoo daw na yung mga kanang misunderstanding ng luha o mga problema. Kaya ko nga si Alvin, kaya ko mulig na ko. And kanatanan tungod na ninyo nga sa simbahan. Dili may nanay sa altar man kun dili tangad ninyo. Thank you so much, Ma, and I promise nga I will stand by his side throughout our marriage or till death do us part. And I promise to love him and take care of him just like how you take care of him. And thank you so much once again, Kuya and Ma.
Salamat sa Ginoon na may mga pabuntagon. Sa paghiwasan. Ako ni pasalamatan ang Ginoon kay ang manuko ng plano sa Ginoon maayo. Kalimu Ilma, Don Alvin, ako lang yung tambang ninyo kakamunduhan ang ibig mga obligasyon sa sabi-sabi. Isip ko sa kamag-iayon, pinag-anay na naagyo na yung mga problema sa kinapuhi. But ato ay yung hinungdumang ito o ba ng Ginoong tungkol kay diha sa Ginoo, ang Ginoo maghatag yung kalinaw na matag-usan. Ako nang maistorya tungkol kay ako po doon ang nasinati na sa usang kaasawa, dilin-dalin sa usang kapinimalay ng asawa. At ako kayo obligasyon. Mana nga, ang paubos na ta, ayun, inampuay, sabi na o, nanay mga anak, ano kaya ni Diyos Ginoo sa mga problema, no? Kaya ang problema, dili ang ngayang takasan. Kaya ang ngayang takasan ng mga problema, hindi rin atubangon yun na siya. Tungkol kaya problema, o di mong maatuba, may kuwan yun mo siya, may kagawasan. Muna na, salamat sa Ginoo ng kamuntagon niya karon. Nagkahiusan ka, mga bisita na ako. O, bonay ako ayun nga ma-istorya sa inyo yung mga ang paghiligong maay na yung ba ang Ginoo pabiling ko na sa Panginoon. Amen.
May request everyone to continue to arise at this time. As we honor the presence of the source of love, God. And so we have gathered here this morning to join our hearts, our favor and time, as this is the God-ordained time for Elma and Alvin to impart one of the most joyful, holy moments in the life of this couple. Now, primarily marriage is a spiritual union. It is such a sacred, holy relationship. Therefore, it should not be entered into lightly. And the good news is God promised to be with you in marriage. To work with you, to assist you, and to make sure that your marriage will be a God-glorifying marriage. To be a couple that sets an example for other couples. And so this morning, it is my privilege and obligation to ask who gave permission for Elma to be given to Alvin. Can I have the raise of hands, the parents? Who gave permission for Elma to be given to Alvin? His parents of Elma, raise your hands. Praise the Lord. So, thank you so much, and we are blessed by your decision to release Elma to be given to Alvin. And so, this morning we will worship the Lord first things first. And I'd like to lead us into a worship time. We cannot proceed with a wedding ceremony without first things first, glorifying and honoring the source of love, and that is God in our midst. And so let us pray. Father, we thank you for your presence. We thank you, God, for your wonderful approval, Lord, and favor to be upon Alvin and Hilma. We ask, O Father, that you will hover around this place and even to their lifelong journey, Lord God, as a couple. God, with all the friends and families and relatives of Alvin and Hilma, we choose to magnify your name and recognize that you are the one faithful and you are the one that is worthy to be praised and be glorified. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Katapatan mo, Diyos, tunay at dakila.
As I read God's word for this wonderful, blessful time in the life of Alvin and Hilma. In Matthew chapter 7, verse 24 to 27, it says, "Therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine and put them into practice is like a wise man who built his house on the rock. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against that house. Yet it did not fall, because it had its foundation on the rock. But everyone who hears these words of mine and does not put them into practice is like a foolish man who built his house on sand. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against that house, and it fell with a great crash." In Psalms 127 verse 1, it says, "Unless the Lord builds the house, its builders labor in vain. Unless the Lord watches over the city, the watchmen stand guard in vain." In 1 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 10 to 14, "By the grace of God has given me a vision as an expert builder, and someone else is building on it. But each one should be careful how he builds. For no one can lay any foundation other than the one already laid, which is Jesus Christ. If any man builds on this foundation using gold, silver, costly stones, wood, hay, or straw, its work will be shown for what it is. Because the day will bring it to light, and it will be revealed with fire, and the fire will test the quality of each man's work." Last passage, Isaiah chapter 28 verse 16. "So this is what the sovereign Lord says, see, I lay a stone in Zion, a tested stone, a precious cornerstone, for a sure foundation. The one who trusts will never be dismayed." So we will close our eyes and please bow down your heads. Father, Lord, in authority under you, O God, we humble ourselves in worship and adoration, knowing, Lord, that you are the foundation of each man's life. And Lord, you are the sure foundation of the life of Alvin and Hilma, even to each one's life and family, O God. We ask that you will bless, O God, this union of hearts, O Father. Even, Lord, even as we part ways, Lord God, after this ceremony, the message, Lord God, will retain and will remain in every heart's mind, heart. Oh God, that they may know you as they, Lord God, experience your love, your care, and your provision. We thank you for this time. We give you praises and thanks in Jesus' mighty name. And everybody says, amen. Kapakan atong ginawa. And of course, let's all, before we sit down, let's all give an appreciation, a clap of appreciation for the boldness and the sincerity of this couple, Alvin and Hilma. Papakan natin. You will now be seated. And please sit down, couple. Let's go to the Word of God first before we proceed with the marriage, right? And this is just short, but I need your attention because you are here not simply to celebrate with them. Friends and families and relatives, you are here because you express your support, no? Close with your couple, and your presence and your attendance here is your sign that you are supporting Alvin, it's you, Hilma, and the Lord. And the Lord Jesus Christ in the Holy Scripture instituted the Lord's Supper. And we call that in a celebration communion. The word communion comes from the word common union. if your marriage will not be mixed and be intertwined with the source of love, and there's no common union in Christ, that is why you are bonded together as strong in Christ. You cannot expect a strong relationship apart from Christ. And so it should be you, your wife, and Jesus. And that's what this communion is all about. The Bible also implies that the bread represents the body of Christ. And we need to understand, on earth, without having this correct understanding of what the body of Jesus Christ represents, that body was hanged on the cross more than 2,000 years ago. And on that cross, Jesus Christ, that body, was actually the very body that represents, that carries all of our sins. That's why Jesus needs to be born. The Word of God from the very beginning, who is the voice of the Father, that Word became flesh. And the very purpose why natao na siyang pulong, ingon ang John chapter 1, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Katong natao, nalawas sa tao, lumao ka to ang pulong ang imong tao, because He needs to represent man. Why? Because ang tao mao'y nagkasala. Kay ang tao nagkasala, ingon sa balaod sa Ginoo, for the wages of sin is death. Kung kinsa ang nakasala, mao'y nagbayad. And so it should be you and me who will pay for our sins. The problem is we cannot pay for our sins. Because the payment must be a perfect payment. Dili man takabayad sa atong sala sa Ginoo. Dili takabayad. That's why here's the sad thing. You know, the Bible says in the book of Luke, you know, what does it profit for a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? Kung sa manang, successful kayo ka, kumplito ka tanan, in love kayo mo sa imong pamilya, nindot kayo mga pamilya, at the judgment day, nagkamatay ninyo, hindi mo kasood sa langit. Why? Because your records is not perfect. Ang makasood sa langit, perfecto lang. Okay? Now please don't judge me on that, because that is not my opinion. The Bible says, those that can enter heaven are those that have perfected the law. Now none of us here, including me, have perfected the law. I am a sinner, and I will continue to commit mistakes, just you and me. That's why I don't trust and I don't depend my life, my marriage life, unto myself. Because one day, I will just be living here on earth more less than 100 years. But I long for the word eternity that I will be living with God forever. And that is my concern. That is why that body was hung on the cross. And Jesus Christ, on that cross, He said to the Father, Father, forgive them. Father means source. Tag-iya sa tanan, tinugtan sa tanan. He said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And in the last word also, He was saying it in Aramaic, in Hebrew, but actually the one that records it, He wrote it in Greek. And the one written in Greek is the word tetelestai. The word tetelestai in English means paid, rather it means it is finished. Okay? So this is kaayo, kung interpret na to, Jesus ningon siya, it is finished, sa Latin consummatum is, ningon siya, patay na po, man na. No, what actually He said on the cross, said, Father, tetelestai, Father, paid in full. And every time I remember that, it melts my heart. Because the meaning of that paid in full is that Jesus Christ paid all of my sins. And He paid all of your sins, past, present, and the future. That is why we need to surrender our life back to where it belongs. It belongs to God. And Jesus paid it all and He died. And that's what this bread represents. Right? And so, as you partake, Alvin, of the symbolic bread, always remember, the life of Christ is in you. Is in you. Is inside of you. Right? So, at this time, as a symbol of common union, and what is yours is hers, and what is hers is yours, please exchange bread at this time as a symbol of fellowship. You and me and Jesus. Alright? Right? You may now partake of the bread. Papakan na ito ang ginawa. Symbolic din na Alvin. You will provide for the table. You will work hard. Kanang ATM, trabaho ka. Also, the Bible says that the wine represents the blood. And praise the Lord. I need to explain this for you to appreciate what a Christian wedding is all about. The the blood which is represented in this juice or in this liquid, the blood actually was the application to our sins. The Bible says, without the shedding of the blood, there is no forgiveness of sins. And the Bible says the blood of Jesus Christ was poured out. Kinahanglan mo agas ang dugo. Walay ang kabayaran sa itong sa dapat na ay mamatay. And the proof na ay mamatay is that on the record in the Bible, that blood was shed and Jesus Christ died. That is why it should be understood as He is dead, because kung hindi siya patay, that means wala mabayari itong sala. Do you believe na namatay si Jesus?
Yes.
That's in the Bible. Do you believe na gilubong si Jesus?
Yes.
That's a proof na namatay din siya. And here's the good news. Do you believe that Jesus on the third day rose from the grave?
Yes.
That means buhi ang tao na nagbayad sa inyong sala.
Yes.
Amen. Isn't that wonderful? Buhi ang tao na nagbayad sa inyong sala. That's why on Judgment Day, listen. On Judgment Day, Satan will be there and he will accuse and he knows all your sins, past, present, and future. On that symbolic judicial court case, Satan will lay down all the records of your sin, great and small. And Satan will be there. He doesn't deserve to be in heaven. He doesn't deserve to be in heaven because these are his records. Praise the Lord. According to the Bible, Jesus will be there also. God with us. And he will be our witness. And he will say, mentioning your name, Satan will mention your name, and Jesus will also mention your name. Lay down, Satan. And Jesus said, all of those sins, I paid it in full.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. That's what that the blood represents. Alvin, you know, everything is paid in full. Yes, magkasala lang yapon ka, but always remember the cross says it all. You are forgiven. Amen. So at this time, as a symbol of fellowship and what is yours is hers, exchange wine at this time. I hope hindi lang iisod ang wine. Tubag din ang ibang natin. You may now drink together. Yung salat, magpaka na ito ang kapo. But again, this is just a symbol. The reality is different because you're going to work hard. But always remember, the essence is what matters. Amen?
Amen.
All of us will leave after this, and all of you will give your gifts and say congratulations. Mabugbugno sa problema, kay mo na lang duha. Praise the Lord, labay parents, no, pwede mo manawag. No, katambag. But then again, God is good. Say amen.
Amen.
So this time, I would like to ask the couple in the congregation, please sit down at this time. Kasi ibang tapon na. And I want you to please kneel down. At this time, I would like to call the veil sponsor to please come at this time.